The story of technology is constant innovation and sort of a replacement of the leaders by new leaders. Who would have thought that Microsoft would not be the major leader today, given the history 15 or 20 years ago? And yet today the leaders appear to be Apple, Amazon, Facebook, Google, maybe a few others. The reason this occurs, of course, is there's technological discontinuities that really do change everything. And I think that's going to continue. The big thing in the last decade have been really two. The first is that consumers really are on the internet, and consumers are, they're just a lot more consumers than there are businesses. So all of the leaders today are essentially consumer focused in one way or the other. And the second thing, of course, is that the architectural change to cloud computing, plus the change in the way PCs work, meant lots of different devices all connected by this network to this very powerful set of cloud computing computers. That model is one that can serve for decades. We can make some educated guesses over the next 5 to 10 years, and indeed in our book we try to do our best. Let me give you some examples. We know that Moore's Law, which is the doubling of computational performance every couple of years, will continue for another 5 to 10 years. There's evidence that it's slowing, and it's possible that it will really slow down in the next 20. So we've got a few more years of that. We know that everyone's going to be online because the prices of everything are falling. And we know that there are already 6 billion people using relatively inexpensive, dumb feature phones. They will all get upgraded, or almost all of them will get upgraded. And we know that a network will come to span them together. What we don't really know is what will people do with those networks and how will governments respond. We speculate that people will, of course, have huge new empowerment applications, which will make their lives much easier, and I think that's a reasonable guess. We also speculate that governments in particular will find the empowerment of individuals counter to some of their policies. In particular, the more authoritarian the government, the more the government is about the powerful as opposed to the people being represented by the government, the more tension there will be as people discover that the governments weren't quite being honest, weren't really quite doing all the right things. And of course, the perpetual problem of corruption and sort of self-dealing that exists in many countries will now be well documented, a new threat to their hegemony. The characteristic of great innovators and great companies is that they see a space that others do not. They don't just listen to what people tell them, they actually invent something new. Something that you didn't know you needed, but the moment you see it, you say, I must have it. Of course, that is shaped by cultural norms and so forth. And the fact of the matter is that large corporations, in particular global ones, are subject to laws that differ by country to country. So the American traditions of free speech may not be those that govern the laws elsewhere. And if you don't figure out a way to deal with that, your employees get arrested. So there's ultimately a check and balance, if you will, on how wild and crazy your innovation can be. But I can tell you that the average person wants their world better. And if you can find a way to improve the world and improve their lives, you can get around stupid government restrictions or other things which are counter the interests of the consumers. I've come to a view that humans will continue to do what we do well, and that computers will continue to do what they do very well, and the two will coexist, but in different spaces. So computers, for example, have perfect memories. They remember everything. And they're particularly good at needle in a haystack problems. So in these 100 pictures or 100 facts, what's different? Very difficult for humans to do those kinds of comparisons. On the other hand, the aspects of human judgment, emotion, creativity, are still difficult for computers to simulate, or at least in a deeper way, really sort of tackle. That may change over the next decades, but for the moment, this separation of powers means that computers will sit around and help you. They'll serve as your assistants. You can talk to your computer will make suggestions. Those suggestions can be highly personal if you allow it. Where should I go? What should I do? Am I late? What are my choices now? And because the computer, exemplified by the mobile phone, which is a highly personal device, backed up by the supercomputer that it's connected to, because that's yours, if you will, it can really make your life better. Certainly at Google, that's our goal.